Hello viewers and welcome to another episode of Lancer Custom Works, where I will be discussing the various mech builds you could make and play with Lancer. Nelson is the embodiment of speed itself, a perfect platform for hit and run tactics with an escape strategy built right into the frame. Nelson's skirmisher trait lets you move after every attack, ignoring engagement and reaction. This means every time you swing your stabby stick, you get to move one space and nobody can stop you from doing it, until you get slowed or immobilized. And with main slash auxiliary and double auxiliary mount, you get to do it twice. When you activates your core power, this additional movement gets even more ridiculous. Not only that, you are also encouraged to move. Momentum gives you more damage on your melee attack after you boost, so Nelson's stats, traits, and everything basically incentivize you to use Nelson like a self-propelling rocket that fuels itself with violence. Its only weakness, low E defense, but just about every interplanetary shipping Northstar mech suffers it, so it doesn't quite count. So, it honestly shouldn't be a surprise that 99% of the following Nelson's builds are all strikers, because when you can move this fast, why use a gun when you can be a bullet yourself? Surprisingly, almost every single piece of Nelson's license are frequently used. Warpike long reach makes hit and run tactic almost danger free to perform, thermal charge is an easy source of more damage, bulwark mods make traversing rough terrain as easy as breathing, knocking people prone with power knuckles make them more vulnerable, ramjet perfectly synergize with Nelson's traits and you can go even faster with it, and even armor lock plating sees frequent uses because getting grappled and unable to dash away is Nelson's worst nightmare. Nelson and its license just work like a well-made clock, that counts the time of death of your enemies. Anyway, let's start compiling 40 Nelson's builds that I have received for this video. I actually got 48 submissions this time, but well, I gotta cut some of them out. Anyway, let's talk about the pure striker Nelson. This is Knockback Nelson. That's the name, I think. What we have here is a very standard Nelson build made to go fast and suplex someone straight to hell. Since this is a striker build, I'm going to refresh your memory on Duelist, Titanomachi, and Siege Ram combo, which easily lets you chain off multiple damaging ram attack off a single melee skirmish. All these damages add up rapidly. Not only that, this build has a thermal charge catalytic hammer, now that's a lot of damage with a chance to stun in one hit. If you want to send people flying, chain up ramjet, juggernaut, supermassive warpike, and the following ram to send your target flying halfway through the map. And of course, because Nelson liked to move fast and use skirmish a lot, having skirmisher talent around is a very nice thing to have, and spaceborne keeps you going in the direction you want. Honestly, catalytic hammer is just so good, so why not stuff it with Roland chamber, OP caliber, and auto stab too, just to make it even more lethal and send someone to next week more reliably. Also, if you are going with loading weapon already, hand cannon will do nicely, especially with combined arms, so you could get even more accuracy out of this combo. And finally, Nelson loves boost anyway, so an addition of jump jet will let it skips over obstacle easily. Screw it, why not just get more hand cannon because you will be frequently reloading anyway, and get gunslinger and vanguard for all the damage and reaction fire too. 10 heat cap also just happens to let you overcharge somewhat reliably, and with synthetic muscle netting, you could easily grapple someone and move them, or just ram the shit out of everything. And of course, it's also okay to not have everything revolving around the hammer. This is an axe to grind, it has a thermal charge chain axe to grind and shred through everything. Interestingly, this build also has full hunter talent set for only a single auxiliary melee, which is going to make it a bit hard to use since you can't quite throw it if you want to use disdainful blade, as otherwise it won't work because you just throw your knuckles away. One not enough, how about two? This build focuses on barraging with two chain axes to absolutely make sure the target is shredded to hell, also cosplaying a Blackbeard with SMN here too. This build also has flicker field, because since Nelson likes moving so much, why not make it able to hide its shape just from moving fabulously? And if you like brawling so much, this build got you. With Brawler, not only can you hit someone you have grappled harder, but all that Titanomachi grapple ram combo can add it up to deal a stunning blow on someone rapidly, and unlike Stormbringer 3 as I found out painfully, it doesn't charge once per round. Also, all that power knuckles are going to make sure nobody is left standing after a barrage. And if you found yourself suddenly grappled by someone you don't want, You have armor lock plating and reactive weave, which let you break the grapple immediately and move away while being invisible. This is very powerful on top of basic brace stuff. And if you want to just focus on slashing someone, just get an auto gun, and maybe hunter lock for more damage. Also, speaking of power knuckles, this is I can't beat the shit out of you without getting closer. I'm pretty sure everyone has the same exact mental image of how Hunter 2 power knuckles would work. Also, this thing can fly, with Ace, because Nelson needs more movement, and Azura, for more actions, and Infiltrator, to be sneaky. But all this can actually be combo into a ludicrously long chain of action for ludicrously speedy movement with core activated. This is positively, ridiculous, and show people why Nelson is the fastest. Of course, you don't really need that ridiculous amount of power knuckles for power knuckles to be good, even one or two would be very nice, and having RMJ and hardpoint reinforcement makes Nelson both fast and tough, a very good combo. Also RMJ needs boost to work anyway. This is the problem with inertia, because of course there's gonna be a Terashima wielding Nelson, which is very tactically flexible thanks to its stance protocol. Also, Jaegerkust 1, which works not as well on a size 1 mech, still brings a ton of movement when the right-sized objects come in, and Croil Rifle, for even more free boost, which integrated Nerve Weave aids in for giving more movement to boost. Croil Rifle also has a rather fun interaction with Walking Armory, that is the mag round, which gives arcing to the rifle, which means you can nail someone over a small hill, and if they decide to run, you can jump jet over the hill and drop kick them immediately, absolutely hilarious. This build also has Mimic Mesh, just to get to somewhere even faster, but it won't work with Flicker Field for invisibility. Going back to Terashima Nelson builds, there's so many Terashima Nelson builds that I had to cut most of them out. This one even has Jaegerkust 2 so it deals even more damage from a single slash, with Accelerate so nothing is impossible to reach. This is Bodhisattva of Broken Noses, which with Tiger Hunter Combat Sheath, it can slug someone right in their face even when being jammed. In fact, you can slug two people right in their face with it, punching them so hard with Molten Reed that they turn into shotgun shell for those around them. A perfect mix with Power Knuckle. Here's another Nelson build with Tiger Hunter Combat Sheath, packing a DSAS this time for even more damage and Ace Jump Jet to get close even faster. And this is Chibzanyov, a hit and run Nelson taken to its extreme by Fade Cloaking after each hit with Fold Knives and Variable Sword, practically avoiding any close encounter, and even if it does take a hit, it can run away quickly with Singularity Motivator. And with Kai Bioplating, it can jump and climb over obstacle like nothing. Not enough Fold Knives. Just get more so you never need to worry about being too close to the enemy again, and with Azura and Redundant System Upgrade, you never need to worry about lack of action or heat for a long while. This is Oh Fuck My Toaster Mech Caught Fire Help, it's a Nelson cosplaying as Tokugawa, with a rather predictable result. With external batteries, the Impact Lance and Annihilator have even longer reach. Deep Well Heat Sink means you can somewhat reduce the amount of heat gain, but even in perfect condition, if you use Plasma Gauntlet, there's a high chance that you will stress your reactor. Having integrated ammo feeds for 5 uses of the gauntlet seems a bit too optimistic, but if you are using the Plasma Gauntlet, you might as well go all in. This is There's No Kill Like Overkill, because if you gonna set someone on fire, might as well put all in on it, with Nuclear Cavalier, OP Caliber, Thermal Charge, Momentum, and Lucifer. This torch is gonna hit extremely hard with a single skirmish, and with Deep Well Heat Sink, you can overcharge reliably with 14 heat cap for even more action. Anyway, I think that's like, more than enough Striker Nelson to last for a couple campaigns. Let's just move on to Striker Controller Nelson, which can use its speed for shenanigans too. This is I was promised a lance, not lasers. It has a whole bunch of thermal pistol and impact lance to pierce through multiple targets, which can charge up Gunslinger quite rapidly, and with Lucifer alongside all other bonus damage, the impact lance can kill things quite effectively. It even has a type 3 shield just for more survivability, and web jaw snare to put it somewhere and then grapple people onto it to make them stay there. This is Violence of Action, it's just a build with a crapton of hand cannon and annihilator, which works well with Vanguard to shoot anyone that moves too close, along with a whole bunch of smoke and BB charges to throw, which with Nelson's mobility and accelerate makes the charges able to reach just about anywhere. This is Lightning Speed, a hack and slash Nelson build with Lesson of TTT and Scanner Swarm to chain both tech and melee attacks, using Beckoner Summon to pull them close and Smite to stun them, making them an easy kill. This is also another TTT core bonus Nelson, using viral logic and aggressive system sync to control your target's movement, or pull them close with Metafold Carver or Beckoner before slashing at them. Spaceborne 3 even somewhat combo into this as it gives +1 difficulty to checks or saves involving slowed and prone, and Hacker 2 is actually quite helpful for anti-tech control with hack slash invade option, which just plain makes your target unable to use tech action unless they reboot, which is quite devastating if it hits like say, a witch, good luck doing nothing when everyone is trying to kill you. This is you only need to be faster than the guy next to you, it's basically a Vlad Nelson with Impaler, Caltrop, and Webjaw to keep people from moving effectively, with Vanguard to shoot the Impaler some more as Overwatch. This is you Better Prey, a Morning Cloak Nelson, with dual variable sword for big damage, Hunter Logic to make your prey vulnerable, and Singularity Motivator to run as soon as it takes damage, perfect for a hit and run platform. And there's Think Fast Chuckle Nuts, a Duskwing Nelson with Burst Launcher to impair distant foes, and can use its ridiculous mobility to either create massive wall with Oasis, or go straight in someone's face and jam them like a mobile flashbang. This can cause a lot of trouble for sure. And so can the rest of the Striker controller builds, but let's move on to the Striker support builds, which can be quite good with Nelson's quick mobility too. This is Crit Fisher, which aside from its dual fold knives Vigilia rocket mounts that take full advantage of combined arms for more accuracies, and thermal charge war pike for big damage, it can throw out ice out drone for anti-tech defense, magnetic shield for kinetic defense, and PCP to send people flying or lock down an idiot that stepped too close. Use as situation demanded. This is Blink Space Tunneler Nelson, I think the name makes it clear what it does. With Nelson's hyper mobility, it can easily make a blink space tunnel to send the entire party right in front of the enemy, and it can still deal a lot of damage to thin out of the enemy rank before the party does so. Hell, it's not even the only blink space tunnel Nelson, this one even has accelerate for even more mobility. And this one can fly to just get over all the obstacles. This is Give Me a Hug, it's a Fomorian Mule Taxi Nelson. Why, I don't know, but it can definitely bring anyone anywhere and destroy anything and any obstacle in the way with Juggernaut Charge and a lot of fists. And even if it can't get Mule Harness, people still give Nelson Fomorian Frame so it can just grapple someone to carry them, because Nelson's Skirmisher trait isn't affected by grapple one bit, as it's not a reaction, you just can't get away from people when grappled. This one even has Veil Rifle to give allies cover even out in the open. And this one has Jump Jet to carry people over cover instead. Not only that, the larger size Nelson is also less vulnerable to being stopped by being engaged by the enemy, so that's even less wasted movement. Anyway, let's just move on to Striker Defender Nelson builds, all two of them. This is Oh, You Are a Chime, a Defender Nelson with Mimic Mesh to get to allies faster, Scorpion to disencourage enemy from hacking you and your nearby buddy, and TTT Hacker combo to hopefully invade a tech controller, shut them down, and smack the shit out of them. You can also just protect your allies by murdering everyone around them, with a Vorpal gun to keep them from firing at your allies. And this is Dragoon, which surprisingly works almost the same except it also has a bunch of drones for a limited area denial thanks to Nelson's short sensor range. And for the final build, we got something very special again, the Soul Artillery Nelson build, and artillery support. This is contrary to popular belief, a super mobile pure gun Nelson that uses its mobility to avoid close combat confrontations with the enemy. The damage properties of Fusion Rifle even encourages you to stay away for bigger damage, especially with crack shot, and mortar to shoot over obstacles, but this is rendered rather pointless by the fact that this Nelson can fly to shoot over obstacles, at least it has 15 range. Also, Athena, to see through everything because why not? And that's all 40 Nelson builds submitted by my audience. Big shout out to all the submitters that have sent their builds to this episode, honestly I just really like how varied all the builds are even in serving the same role of going in fast and smash things apart, I hope you guys all have fun in reading through the builds as much as I did too. Anyway, here's the topic for next episode, that's all for now and I will see you all next time. Hello there, if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and click that notification bell button. If you really want to support my channel, you could visit my Patreon page, or buy me some Ko-fi, links in the description. Anyway, have a nice day.